Welcome to Lab 1, Week 1 of Cloud Security, Lab a Week. I'm really excited to get started with these labs. And the very first thing we need to do is create our Amazon account for everything we're going to be doing going forward. Now, it's really important to use a brand new account. We're going to be doing a lot with these. Some of them are going to open up some security flaws so we can learn how to fix those flaws. You don't want to do that on an existing account. Also, it's going to make sure that there's no conflicts or problems later as we set everything up. Another important aspect of this is that this account is going to be the management account for our organization. An organization is a construct that Amazon added a while back that allows you to organize dozens, hundreds, or even thousands of Amazon accounts hierarchically. It's what we use anytime we're working in an enterprise environment or any kind of a corporate or nonprofit environment. You're always going to go ahead and be creating an Amazon organization. And the security of everything you do is going to start with that management account and how you have it set up. Now, Amazon's a little weird. Over on Azure and on Google, they were built to have this hierarchy from the start. But, you know, unfortunately for Amazon, they were years ahead of the rest of the market, and they didn't build that capability in because we didn't even know we needed it yet. So it's something they added on later, and that's why it's got some quirks associated with it. And one of those is you don't start by building an organization, you start by building one Amazon account. Now, to further confuse things, within your Amazon account, when you sign up, and we're going to go through the sign-up process live today, in the sign-up process, you're going to create your root account. The root account is like ring zero for all of your Amazon accounts. If somebody can get into that root account, they can completely control that Amazon account. And if that's your management account, that gives them a lot of access to your entire organization. And we're going to go over a few techniques to make sure that we have that root account for your management account secured appropriately. Now, this can be a little bit confusing as we talk about this. We have a root account and a management account, and one thing's an Amazon account, and the other thing's your user account, and it's all confusing, and yeah, we get to blame Amazon for all of that as well. The words that I like to use that we're now actually using over at the Cloud Security Alliance are deployments. So an Amazon account is a deployment. An Azure subscription is a deployment. A Google project is a deployment. That's just a generic term that, to be honest, I kind of made up, so that we would have a better ability to describe these things. So this is going to be our first deployment. It's our first AWS account, and we're going to create our root account inside of it. Before we go into that, there's two things we're going to need. One is we're going to need access to email, because that's what the core, that's all the security around your root account. Your unique identifier is your email. You'll also need your phone. A phone is part of the process of setting up your accounts. It's also part of the process of setting up your multi-factor authentication, which is required. Now, if you don't have it, pause the video, grab your phone, and download an app called Authy, A-U-T-H-Y. The Authy app is the one that I'm going to use today, and it's really simple and easy to use for your multi-factor authentication. All right. Now, with that said, I want to actually review the email process that I recommend and the kinds of accounts. So I'm going to pull up a little bit of a whiteboard here on my screen. You want to be using an email address that supports something known as plus addressing. An example of this is Gmail over at Google. What I mean by that is that if I have the email address, say, test@gmail.com, if I write an email to test plus SLAW@gmail.com, that's going to go ahead and route back to my main inbox, gmail.com, test@gmail.com. And you don't need to do anything to configure this. This is just turned on by default, and it works pretty well. I have it actually set up. You can use it in Office 365 and a bunch of other places. The reason this is important is, from a security standpoint, there are two critical things that if an attacker gets into, they can take over your account completely. The first one is that the root account. There's a lot of phishing attacks against it. People know about this. It's a huge liability, because if they can get to that, the email associated with your root account that we're about to set up, they can take over the entire environment. So you have to be really careful about setting that up. Well, one of the things that I do to prevent phishing, and this is a recommendation I make everywhere I go, is to use a pattern, but to use a pattern that the bad guys aren't going to be able to figure out. So the pattern that I use, hopefully no bad guys are listening here, is pretty simple. It's the project name that we're working on. So say it would be SLAW, which is Security Lab a Week, why we're here. Then I put the environment, so like dev tester prod dash. Then I put in a cryptographically generated seed. Now, right now I'm going to bang my keyboard. So that's not a good cryptographically generated seed, but that's what I would go ahead and use if I was going to be using this in a real corporate or organization enterprise environment. I actually generate those. I have one password. I generate a password. I throw the seed in, then I throw it away. You don't need it for anything other than this. Then you set that up at whatever your address is. It won't be necessarily gmail.com, but mycompany.com. Now, once you've set this, you're going to make sure this goes to a distribution list. And there's kind of three key or parts of your organization that you do want to have on this distribution list. So one's going to be the account owner, because they're going to get important emails like something's going to be patched automatically by Amazon, or this server's going down because you didn't set it up. Then it'd be, let's call it IT ops. And then the last is going to be security. Now, you can mix and match this a little bit. In some places, they don't send those emails to the account owner. It goes to some kind of a cloud operations, security operations. But it is important to keep track of these things because you will get important emails on those. The other important one is the phone. You do not want to just use your corporate phone number for this, because if the attacker can call the phone number and get it routed to them by tricking somebody at the switchboard, that's another way that you can actually lose access to your account. With that, let's jump into the lab part itself. This should take about 10 to 15 minutes to go through the process. First thing you want to do is go to aws.amazon.com and create an AWS account. You are also going to need an email address, a credit card. I almost forgot that part. And I'll have to pause the screen and go get my credit card because it's not in my pocket right now. When you sign up, you're going to set your root user email address and the name of the account. Now, I'm going to set one up. I'm actually not going to reveal it as I go through here. So you can see those are just my autofills on some of my emails. But let me go ahead and switch over. You get to look at my face while I do this. And type in my address in. You can guess that the name I'm going to use is going to be a name that's going to help me remember for these labs, and verify email address. Now I'm going to have to switch over to email and make sure that that's me. I will actually go ahead and do that real quick. So switching over to my email program and checking my email inboxes. So I actually have some mail filtering that can kind of sometimes filter these little pieces out. And once I do that, I'm going to go ahead and click, and that will activate my account. So everybody go ahead, do this process on your own. I'm going to do a little bit of editing here to get out the dead space. Okay, it took about 2 minutes for that email to come through all my various filtering, and I have my verification code. I'm going to go ahead and paste that in and hit verify. Yay! So now I need to set up my password, and I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to pause the screen again, set up my password. We'll come back after I get logged in. Okay, I entered in my secure password. Now I'm going to go ahead and put all my contact information in. Pretty straightforward process. So we'll go on pause again because I don't think you all need to know all of my personal information. I don't know. You can probably get it on the dark web or, well, pretty much anywhere else anyway. But let's go ahead, enter the information, and we'll be right back. Now for the important part, at least as far as Amazon is concerned. We need to go ahead and enter in our credit card information. Another really important thing is for any of the phone numbers you enter, make sure you have that phone with you. You have to have the phone in order to successfully complete this process. I'm going to go on pause and I'm going to enter my info again. Now, I entered my credit card. This is the important part here. This is where you have to have your phone number. So it's got to be a cell phone associated with this. I'm going to go ahead and set it up so it's going to send me a text message. And I'm going to have to validate that text message. This is to make sure that every account is associated with a real person, supposedly. So I'm going to go ahead and enter all of that and we'll be right back. Now, some of you may have noticed that that CAPTCHA is probably the worst in history. I hate the ones that Amazon uses. You have to use that most of the time when you're using your root account and those come up. So then we go ahead and I'm going to pull up my verification code in my text messages here. Don't worry, this is not a secret. Of course, I have to be able to read it. Then I'm going to go and choose my support plan for what we're doing here. We'll stick with the basic support for free. You can always change that whenever you want. It's really easy. That's it. Our account is set up. Let's go ahead and log into our account, make sure we've got our right access. And I think Amazon's going to force us to set up our multi-factor authentication right away. Clicking on go to the AWS Management Console. Now we're going to be logging in as our root user. You can see I blurred out some of the other ones that I have out there. Actually, those aren't really even all that important. And the root user email address is going to be the email address that we use to set up this account. Now, starting in next week or the week after, we're going to go ahead and set up an administrative account, and you'll never really have to use your root email address again, but you do need to use it today. So let me flick off. I'm going to go ahead and type mine in. Then it's going to prompt me for the password. You should all be following along yourselves. And I have too many passwords stored. There we go. I've got the right one. And now I've gone ahead and I'm logged into the AWS console as my root account. Now, you know you're logged in as your root account because it'll show up in the upper right-hand corner. And that'll pop up. And anytime that you're in your account, it will look a little bit different if you're logged in with different kinds of users. And those are things that we're going to go ahead and talk about later. Okay, I had to cut away for a second there because I had gotten an email from Amazon that they were going to be requiring MFA for all new root accounts. That doesn't start until 2024. And well, I'm recording this in 2023. That said, we want to go ahead and set that up right away because it's absolutely critical. If somebody gets into this root account, they're going to own this account. They can do whatever they want with it. The way to do that is to start by going to your C credentials. So I'm going to flip over to the upper right corner, click on my name, and go to security credentials. And you'll see right up at the top, you do not have MFA assigned. This is again where you're going to use the Authy app. Now, if you have Duo or Google Authenticator or Microsoft Authenticator, whichever one of those you want to use, you can use. But I'm going to be demonstrating using Authy. I actually have all of those I use for different kinds of things. Click Assign MFA. And we have to give a device name. I'm going to just call it Authy. And we're going to use an authenticator app. In future labs, I'm actually going to show you how to use hardware security keys. But for today, we're just going to use the Authy app and what's known as a virtual MFA. Click Next. Now we've got to set up our device. And you're going to see me walk through these steps. So I'm opening up my Authy app. And I'm going to hit the Add Account button. And then I'm going to choose the option to scan the QR code. Now my Authy app is already authorized for my camera. So I'm going to click there, picked it up right away, and now I have to enter these two codes. So let's go ahead and put name in. I'm going to call this one SLAW because that way I can remember it from my other ones. And then I have to click on it. So you'll notice that that's the one that's up on my screen right now. I need to put in two codes in a row to sync things up. So there's the first code. I was once teaching a class. Somebody saw me do this. So I'm like, we can hack into your account. No, no, you really can't. And I'm just waiting for the timer to go ahead and stop. It really becomes very uncomfortable when I'm staring at a camera as I'm waiting for this clock to tick over. All right, here we go. And my next code. And add MFA. I have green. Everything worked. You should have green yourself. That's it for our first lab, for our first lab. I'm talking weird. I don't get it. And the key points that I want to make sure that you understand here is, one, we're using a clean account because we're going to be doing a lot of labs and experimentation, but also it's going to be the management account for an entire Amazon organization as we go down the road. And because Amazon made organizations as a bit of an add-on, there's no hierarchy right from the beginning. You have to create and secure your first AWS account, and then you can use that to build your organization. Then we talked about using different kinds of email and my recommended pattern, which is going to be the project name dash the environment dash a cryptographically generated random. I just banged on the keyboard, but normally what I use is my 1Password or whichever, or LastPass, whatever app you're going to use to generate that password. And I add that on at yourorganization.com.org. The reason is attackers aren't going to be able to guess that email address. Not easily. If they can figure that out, it means they've hacked your email server or they've hacked Amazon. That's the only way that they should be able to get into that cryptographically generated email. So it really is going to help you from a security and an incident response standpoint figure out what's going on if you ever do see phishing attacks against that. This was used to create our root account, and the root account is the Ring 0 for your Amazon environment. It's the most sensitive account. So we went ahead and then we added multi-factor authentication to it. Now we're going to get much deeper into some of the securing of your hierarchy. There's some additional security settings we're going to go through as we go along that are going to help make your life a little bit easier. But that's it. We've got our account. We're all set up. Now, for those of you that are joining us later and kind of jumping ahead to the labs, I would wait a little bit because it can take about 24 hours for a new Amazon account to completely bake in and for all the features to be enabled. So you might run into a few headaches if you try and do a lot with a brand new Amazon account when you first set it up. Most of our labs should be fine, but just a little bit of warning there if you do ever run into that in the future. That's it. Thanks for your time. I'm really excited to start this program. We're going to be doing so much over the coming months and hopefully over the coming years as we get really in depth. But we've got to start at the beginning, and we just did that. Have a great day.